Bastri, ho.
Wow.
Voces en destera, mos en destera.
Incredible.
I had no idea.
Pursue
this talent.
It hurts.
Wow. Hello, everyone, and welcome to a very Christmassy special of Cold Ones. I'm your host, Anything for Views. Joining me today is my co-host.
Hello, I'm Max Mofo.
And our guest today, Misfits members, Swagger Souls and Fits.
Hey, that's us. We're here.
Thank you to today's sponsors, State of Survival, mobile app, and we'll kick it off. Yeah. What? Oh,
cool
fuck.
Shirts.
And cool shirts.
Can't forget about the bread and butter.
Yeah. Head over to shirtswithaz.cool and use code COLONS 10% off. This looks nice, though. You did a good job on these ones, Scott. Last year's sucked. You guys want
to
do shots?
I'll do a shot.
I have to do it with a straw.
I also have to, because I have these.
Oh.
Invisalign.
He's fixing his fuck teeth.
Are we doing the shot
right
now?
Yeah, we'll do the shot now.
To a Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year. Wait.
What? Can we all drink them through a straw?
Yeah.
Just. Terrible, though.
Let's do it.
Just one, just so you know what it's like.
To the straws. I'm not cheersing.
Right, straw shots.
This is fucking terrible.
Oh, it was soju. That's fine.
Oh, soju.
It's making vodka.
That's good.
Yeah.
Delicious.
I'll drink that through a straw all day. Okay, that wasn't so bad. I got that scared.
That was good.
Before we begin about talking about whose fits has piped and who he hasn't, let us bring up the drinking game. The game is, there is cards and we go left to right. You pick up the card and it's something that you have to tweet. If you don't want to tweet it, you have to drink the amount of drinks that's written on the card.
Oh, easy,
dude. Have to tweet it right now or?
Right now.
All right.
Okay.
I haven't tweeted in like a month.
Okay, my first card says, anyone got a plug on heroin in Melbourne? DM. Serious in brackets.
How many shots?
Wait, why is that three drinks?
Three drinks?
That's a fuck tweet.
That's not that bad. You can get away with that, no problem.
You know what? I want to set an example of not being a pussy here.
And you might also get a heroin plug out of this. So dude. It's just a win-win.
There, okay. I've done the tweet. It's up, okay? Right.
The fact that there's a typo and it makes it seem like you're actually like on your last wit looking for heroin.
People think I'm serious.
Oh, this is a pussy out. Only one drink for this one. Hey, at OnlyFans, can you help me out? I was double charged for 13 out of my 19 subscriptions. Need immediate refund, thanks.
Come on, do that.
It's just one drink. I'll just take the drink.
Oh, come on, Max, tweet it.
I would say tweet it, but I don't think it's funny.
Your turn, Fitz.
Oh, shit. Are these ordered
in
a specific way? For two drinks. Yeah, I fucked your girlfriend. What are you gonna do about it, pussy?
It wasn't ordered?
I can't be getting in all this drama all the time. I'm not even uploading. Can you imagine if I did?
Like, if you did, it'd be not right.
You can disastrous. You can explain.
You just gotta wait 2 months for the contest. Then you'll be out of jail.
I wanna see at least two big mouthfuls out of
that. Alright, I'll drink the whole fucking thing, you know?
Okay.
That was very funny. I wish I could tweet it. I really do.
All right, I guess it's my turn now. At Tommy Innit, DM me when you're 18. No, dude.
Oh, come on!
No.
Why? I would tweet that.
How many drinks?
It's only for two. So like,
that's funny. That's a funny tweet.
Because it's not open, I feel like that's a harder one to say is a joke.
It's just a direct ad.
It's so clearly a joke. I think that's funny.
Come on, funny.
Yeah, why not?
Yes! Finally! Some balls at both ends of the tail of the God cradle of the fucking pussy.
It's gonna come out as a joke eventually.
Why is my father calling me?
Oh my God, his dad is actually calling him.
Answer, speaker.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey dad, what's up? You're not calling about the heroin, are you?
Whatever.
Okay, don't worry, don't mind. What's up?
Well, I was saying that, and we can take acid and
everything. Oh, when you come and visit?
Yeah, is that what you're talking about? I've seen that on the news, the first date that's legalizing drugs or something.
You stop watching A Current Affair. You're too old. It's going to cripple your brains.
You tell your dad to be funny.
Dad, say something racist.
something racist.
Oh, sorry. No, don't do that. I'll call you back later, but I'm filming right now, but I'll look at the email soon, okay?
Yeah, that's for racist.
Love you, baby boy.
All right, bye.
Wholesome. Chad, you're up.
Next card. Why do I get all the three drink ones? I'm in full support of making coronavirus vaccine mandatory. It ends up causing autism. Fine, more subs for me. That's hilarious. That's fucking awesome. I would definitely tweet that sober. Scott, I didn't know these were reward cards.
He's going to go from the heroin tweet straight to that. Like,
they're definitely going to get some heroin now. I shouldn't have done the heroin one. Max, you're up.
For two drinks, just tested positive for COVID. Cringe.
I'd take the drinks. That's a too mad tweet.
They're going to think that's serious for sure.
Yeah.
But that's okay.
Yeah, I'll tweet that.
Tweet that.
Is there one in there about him fucking Caterino as well?
Is it your turn, Cam?
It is my turn. Okay, ready. Right. Just finished Cuties on Netflix. Highly recommend it. Hashtag ad, hashtag Netflix partner.
Oh, please.
I mean, okay.
That's so good.
Wait, you are tweeting that?
I mean, I feel bad for not tweeting the last one. This one's not so bad. This one,
that one's not so bad.
It's the pedophile movie, right?
The hashtag ad, hashtag Netflix partner sells
at
that.
At the very least, at least it's just a sponsored deal. So they'll be like, well, we can understand. Money. Man's trying to get a bag, like, you know. All right, it's tweeted. I can't believe right. I just tweeted that. Okay.
So when are you going to tell them about us at Pokimane?
Oh, please. How many drinks is that?
Three drinks.
Please.
She'll appreciate the joke.
Will she?
We can DM her after and be like, look, we were doing a show.
Drama channels will think it's real.
If I'm just going to fucking tweet
it. Yeah. Just tweet it. This might be your best tweet. Someone just asked me saying, you're digging your own grave, man.
Nerd City just texted me. He said, COVID. Are you joking? How would even find it?
All right, Chad, you're up.
I cannot tweet this.
What is it?
I've been sleeping with fans for years, and I have to say, highly recommend it. The breeze really helps me doze off after having rough sex with my subscribers.
The breeze?
For the fans.
That's funny. Oh, what the fuck? I'm getting great ones. I just got it.
That's a Scott tweet.
Oh.
To cool off after having sex with his subscribers, though.
It's like a creepy dad joke.
Yeah. It's awesome. It's like, you should cut off the fan part. She made it look like I've been fucking my fans.
That was the whole joke.
What the fuck are you saying?
Fucking next one. Go on.
Okay, this is for two drinks. My next video is nearly finished, and it's my most racist one yet. Make sure you ring that bell. I'm drinking for that one.
Oh, what?
I'm not following up. I have COVID with I'm racist.
Oh my God, this is a very long one. For two drinks. Excited to be a guest tonight on my favorite talk show at Cold Ones. Make sure you give them a follow. Their podcast is excellent and far better than our one. And I mean that. I am not being forced to say that. That is my honest and true opinion. Hashtag Cold Ones.
Wow, I wish I got that one.
You know what? I honestly wholeheartedly agree.
No!
And I'm happy to tweet that. Because if anything, it just proves that everything I'm about to tweet.
That's an immediate indicator.
It's a joke.
Yeah. Right? It's fine.
It's kind of like my get out of jail free card.
But that kind of ruins it.
Yeah, but shut the fuck up, swagger souls. Drink. I mean, it is kind of lame though. It does kind of defeat the
point. It gives it away.
Drink.
I'll take fucking 10 minutes to write out.
Fine, I'll drink more.
There goes the fun.
And that's why my phone has so many cracks on it.
This is for one drink. Excited to announce I've partnered with @Reddit as a hashtag Reddit Gold featured creator. Let me know what subreddits I should check out in the replies and follow me on Reddit. Reddit.com/user/sloppytitty69 #Reddit #Reddit partner #ad. I'm drinking.
Next one.
A swagger needs another drink, Krupa.
Krupa Trooper. Oh, hey, President Editor is a Koopa Trooper. Yes, I was on the Epstein flight logs, but... But I can assure you that I was simply going fishing with the boys. The reason I'm on there so much is because I really like fishing. Another good tweet. I'm doing three drinks. That does suck.
Do you like zombies? No? Me neither! That's why I play State of Survival! Set in the not-so-distant future, you play as a survivor of a global catastrophe. You must work to rebuild your home, grow and design your settlement, and most importantly, slaughter the zombie hordes! There is also a limited-time Christmas in-game event for December 20th to the 25th with limited-time holiday skins available. This is my favorite champion at the moment, Lucy, a scary woman who literally shoots saw blades! Not content with fighting the brain dead? They also have PvP modes, where you can battle against your real-life friends. Or you can try Explorer Trail, where you explore unknown areas of the world and fight waves of zombies. But that's not all. The game also has an exciting story featuring the evil genius Klein, no relation to Ethan, who unleashed the zombie virus upon the world. And it's your job to stop him. So download State of Survival or else! That's not a threat, or is it? Oh, and once you're on State of Survival, remember to join our alliance. It's called GROG. Furthermore, if you download State of Survival using our link below, you will be entered into one of 10 Cool Shirts survival kit giveaways that include a hat, a mask, and some discontinued merch. And when you do, use the creator code COLDONESSOS to redeem a starter pack, which includes a starter hero, Rusty, and 2,000 bio caps. That's a lot of bio caps. Thanks to State of Survival for supporting this show, and thank you guys for supporting them. Okay, back to the show.
All right, for two drinks, just filmed a new video with the whole gang, posting once this tweet hits 500K likes.
That's it.
Come on, bro.
It's never gonna get that many likes.
It's implying the whole gang.
Like Ian and George.
Oh, as in Ian and everything, yeah.
I think that's kind of mean.
That is kind of mean.
I'll do the next one, whatever it is.
I can't wait to see that. Go on, Fitz. Pick the next one.
How was it my turn again already? Trying to keep up with uploads on the main channel has taken its toll. Gonna take a few years off. Thank you for understanding. All right. I mean, that's just an excellent tweet for me, I think.
This one is for one drink. 9/11 was the opposite of poggers.
That's an excellent tweet. You would tweet that anyway.
It's only one drink.
Oh, come on.
That's so funny.
It was 10 years
ago,
bro.
The more fucked up shit you tweet, the more clear it is that you're fucking drunk and it's a joke.
Yeah, I mean, it's not wrong, because 9/11 wasn't very
poggers. It wasn't poggers at all, no. What is it? Honestly, it was kind of a Pepe sad moment.
That's new main channel upload in the next 48 hours.
That sucks for you.
Yeah, I'm just going to tweet it, because I'm actually...
What the fuck? No!
I'm 10 max.
Okay, for three drinks... I hate women.
That's it.
I said I have to
no matter what.
You have to tweet that.
That is hard for me to do. That is
a really hard one for sure.
Two men
replied immediately. saying what the fuck?
Serious question. Is it normal for poo to come out both assholes at once? Also, is it normal to have two assholes asking for a friend?
That sucks.
That's a shitty tweet.
That's weak. Can I be banned for that?
No.
No, you're verified. You're fine.
Yeah, it's just an opinion.
It's just an opinion.
This is for two drinks. Can we stop fat shaming? Unlike being black or gay, no one chooses to be fat. Have some respect.
That's a slapper. That's a slapper. Come on. Everyone already thinks you're hacked.
All right.
If they get mad, then fuck them. Worst comes to worst, we can always blame it on the fat heroin addict and the woman hater.
This is true. Very true.
Don't worry about it.
For the final round.
Oh, shit.
We're doing custom cards.
Oh, shit.
Each person has two blank cards. You write a tweet, then we shuffle them all together and we play the game again.
How about we raise the stakes for this one, and if you say no, it's a shot.
All right, soju.
No.
We still have to ask questions. I don't want to die. I want this to be somewhat informative.
Yeah. I don't have any fucking questions.
I'm going to take one off the top. I don't know whose card it's going to be. Oh, this is red one.
That's mine.
I'm so sick of at Susan Wojcicki censoring me on YouTube. If anyone knows where to get rid of this woman, send me a DM.
I just like how it's where to get rid of her. It's not like how.
I think I just read it wrong. All right, I'll drink. I don't want to go on the fucking blacklist next to fucking.
So we've said enough about that woman.
She's not even that bad.
Max, your turn.
Max, you're up, bro.
The H3H3 podcast. Seriously sucks. I don't know how anyone can sit through that shit. There's no way I could ever.
Why would you write that?
Why are you looking at me?
You said black pen. Who's black pen?
That ain't
me or.
Why would you guys write that?
I didn't write that.
Probably Chad.
Chad's got a black pen. Mine's fucking. Just I have a black pen.
Yeah, I'll take a shot for that.
Oh, no.
I'd love to see Chad do that one.
No, I don't think I will.
For Susan and Ethan Klein.
May they live happily ever after. Chad's cock is so fat. That shit seriously makes me horny. Full caps.
Read that.
Chad's impressed.
This was yours for sure.
Yeah.
I don't want to lie on my Twitter.
Okay, there, okay. That's fair. I'll, fuck yeah.
I'll do the soju.
You should.
Oh, why no? I'll do the soju. Fucker.
Your cock's, you know. It's there. You know, it's... I'll have a shot.
This one is, for one shot, written in red pen. I hate women in all caps.
Hey, that makes two of us.
I'll have a shot.
Why?
What? If you tweet it as well, then it almost makes it better for everyone. Think about that. Because it's like, you know,
yeah,
sure,
but it's
you
not
both
true.
Hate women, but at least you have friends.
I say we revisit the last four at the end. They'll be there.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, we need to get informative. Because
both of mine are still in there, so I'm quite excited. Okay.
And both of mine are also still in there.
Oh, so it's just you two, so we're going to have to just pick them up. Let's talk about your drug addiction.
I wouldn't say I'm addicted to anything except weed. The weed's like my constant. Weed's just like, weed helps my anxiety, you know? And it also doesn't help my anxiety at the same time.
Because you both smoke it religiously, right?
I mean, got into weed because of this guy.
Yeah. Well, thanks for putting all the blame on me.
But, and Ryan. I'll put some blame on Ryan.
Ryan like, is the fucking peer pressure king.
My relationship with weed is like constantly evolving. At the beginning, I was like, I love weed. I smoke it like all the time and I can edit and I can like record and like I could be like functional like when I'm on it. But it's gotten to a point where, like, I smoke weed and I get anxiety, so I can't stream when I'm stoned. I don't record the podcast when I'm stoned. When I get stoned, I just want to, like, chill out and not do anything else. So I've kind of shifted how I'm using it because it's less of a tool for me now and it's more of like a reward. Because I'm a YouTuber, I don't fucking clock out of work. I don't have work hours and I'm like, yeah, I'm going to work till 9. And then after that, I chill. It's like as soon as I'm done editing or as soon as I'm done streaming and I know I have nothing on for the night, then I'll load up a bowl and I'll smoke it and then I'll do whatever I want. And so it's like to relax at the end of the night.
I don't drink very often. What the fuck are you talking about?
I seriously don't drink as often.
Chad drinks the most out of everyone I know.
It's like a reverse AA meeting where we don't have a problem.
The most to you is like, because you drink only when we do this. I never see you drink.
Once a week? That's pretty regular.
Yeah, but I'll have, after we do our filming, I'll go out and hang out with these guys for a weekend because you sit at home opening children's playing card games and don't socialize with anyone.
Okay, let's turn the blame back on something.
Okay, no.
Because you don't want to face your demons.
And then I get fucking drunk one night of the week and I say I'm hungover the next
three nights a week.
No, one extra, two nights a week.
Chad be like, I only had one sip of wine. And all right, so like three bottles.
Let's talk about the issues between you guys because clearly there's a bit of tension here.
We can do a little bit of marriage therapy.
Yeah, I think you guys need it. I think you could use it. All right, so do you think that Cold Ones as a whole has helped your relationship or made it worse between the two of you?
I don't think it's really changed.
Yeah.
It'd be how it'd be.
So that's not a good answer.
What do you mean? What do you mean by that? Go on.
Yeah, what do you mean by that, Max?
Yeah, no, it's good.
Okay,
I like coming in here and hanging out with my mate Chad.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm obviously teasing.
As long as he's paying me half.
I'm obviously teasing. You guys are a great combo, I think.
Yeah.
It's
gone good.
Yeah, I love being really on good. Max Mofo's podcast.
Oh, I'm going to go.
Chad, I message you all the time and say I really enjoyed the latest episode of Call One.
Yeah,
you know,
you
it's
message him at the same time too.
Well, Max doesn't do fucking anything. Let's be honest, he just fucking shows up.
Ask him a question while I'm pissing.
Shut up.
Let's flip this around on our dynamic.
What's going on? What's the problems in misfits?
If you were gonna give me a piece of advice or a suggestion on how to improve my life, what would it be?
Talk to your friends more. About your issues. Like, if you're ever going through anything, like, you have to understand that you have, like, a support structure around you.
That's true. That's true. And I, you know, it's funny because I always used to be the one to be like, let's talk about everything. Let's talk about everything. But yeah, that's a valid point.
Yeah.
And you know what? I love you.
I love you too, bro. Over lockdown, we've grown so much closer.
It's true.
Have
you?
No comment.
What was it like in the old days when you were filming the crazy videos? You know, the videos where you were naked and you were vomiting.
That was Chad fighting for more rights.
For more rights?
Rights. Yeah.
What does that mean?
What do you mean?
More human rights.
As a whole or for him personally?
For him personally.
So what do you mean?
What rights were you deprived of, Chad?
Human rights.
Just human rights.
So what? They would tell you to do something and you just
well, need to explain. Well, he got lit on fire. And right, got, I remember that. You know, he was like, I think Cold Ones has given him something to be like, enough is enough.
Is that right? You just tweeted out that you hate women.
Hey, someone bit my arm on that one.
Lately, he's been one taking all the fucking shitty things. So we did the how it does a carbonate thing. There were so many things I wouldn't drink that he just fucking did it.
That's all good fun, though. So yeah. That stuff is...
it kind of pales in comparison to being lit on fire.
Does this mean that like all the crazy things that you did in the old videos with, you know...
I think that's sort of initiation.
Right.
So it was your hazing.
Were you true. Chad, just like doing whatever the idea was
the
just
the
to fit in?
The rewards were always there.
Well, because he didn't have a channel. He wasn't really doing anything.
Yeah, I didn't have any
there was
money.
No channel. It was just like, oh, do you want to be in this video? Do you want to do this? Do you want to do that?
Yeah.
I think Filthy Frank put the Anything for Views name came from a Filthy Frank video, right?
Mm. Yeah. He kind of shot himself in the foot by adopting the Anything for Views name because then like... What fucking good are human rights? Someone whose name is Anything for Views.
True. Like,
it's a good excuse. It implies you'll do anything. It's also a good excuse if I do something stupid. I can be like, man, it's in the name.
We're all past that now, though. Yeah. We've got Cold Ones. Yeah. We're doing big things.
You are. Cold Ones is a great fucking show.
I love every Cold Ones episode. Yeah, I love all the shit that you guys make. With
hey, this isn't about us. You guys.
Listen, we're just being the host because you guys are so bad at it.
It's been a fucking while.
You said this last time. I warned Chad. I was like, last time he shit on our fucking show. If we have no questions for him, he's going to shit on it again.
You're right. See, I just turned 24 and I'm already so aware of how close 26 is. I know I'm going to be there before I know it.
My sister's 40 this year.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Damn. She hot?
Nah, she's had two kids, two divorces. Right. I mean, you can. It'll be funny.
Nah, I won't do
you
that.
You can actually.
Nah, it's all right.
I'll pay you.
Nah, fuck it.
She needs a husband.
Maybe we can be like a nice little like H3 Trisha Paytas moment where I'm having sex with your relative and we talk about it on a podcast.
Trisha. It's funny. It's like watching a train wreck. You love watching train wrecks. But she's a train wreck, but at the same time she can be like queen. I don't know. I like her. I really like Trisha Paytas. Like
I'm glad the internet has Trisha Paytas. There are many characters on the internet that although they might be slightly dodgy characters, I'm glad the internet has them. The internet needs more colorful personalities that do fucked up shit because there's so many boring cookie cutter influencers now that are just being a good role model and, you know, looking out for the younger generation. Fuck that.
Who's your favorite YouTuber now? Like, if you had to pull up a YouTuber, what would your favorite YouTuber be?
Mr. Beast. Matt Pat from Game Theory. No, not really.
Man, I really fuck with Jay Schlatt. I think he's hilarious.
Yeah, Schlatt.
I love Schlatt as a friend, and I genuinely, since like the day I met him, I was like, this kid's got it. Like, he's fucking...
If I met him...
Yeah.
I'm sure
I can't remember. You see, the thing is, when we go on
trips... We went camping with him.
But I was drunk the whole time. Yeah. See, the thing is, when we go on trips together... listen, I'm away from... It's different. I'm on camera. It's funnier when I'm wasted. Every time we go on trips, I always like follow people while I'm drunk and they DM me and I can't remember ever meeting them.
Right.
The only reason I knew Carson was because of the meme. I didn't know Slat. I didn't know Traves. I didn't know fucking... I didn't, you know, I now know.
Yeah.
But like at the time, I can't fucking remember.
I said that same shit. It's just like... Any of those situations, just the clusterfuck of influences. And I'm just like, okay, obviously you're somebody.
Yeah.
But I'm like, I don't know who they are. Even though maybe I'll even follow them all on Twitter, but I still don't know. I mean, you look familiar, maybe.
You meet lots of influencers, but every so often one of them comes along and you're like, okay, this person switched on and they're actually funny.
Mm. Right.
And I would say that Schlatt's one of those people.
Yeah, like, Schlatt is... The fucking homie.
My favorite YouTuber is Bo Miles. He's actually from Melbourne.
Bo Miles?
You know the Bean Man? I always link him.
Bean guy, yeah.
He's my dream fucking person to have on the podcast. He's just some like true blue Aussie legend. Like his recent video was Junk Cabin, secretly building my wife a COVID office. But it's like really, he's got like a film producer's mind. It's great. I don't watch like YouTubers that I know now. I just want to find
When
someone.
You're on the inside of the business, you can see through all the shit that all these YouTubers are doing. You're like, oh, I know what you're doing. You don't mean that. You don't love your fans, you fucking tool. More than anything, people value authenticity on YouTube because there's so much fucking vapid bullshit. When you find something that actually feels like a person, it's like, oh my God, like I can get behind
Especially
this.
Especially nowadays with people all trying to get in, corporations and stuff trying to be like, I'm a cool kid doing YouTube.
I'm part
How
of
do subscribe you do, to fellow me. Kids? It's me, The Rock, Johnson.
The Rock is part of CLG. We're cool. Like all those big celebrities like joining FaZe Clan and shit like that. I'm like, wasn't FaZe Clan a bunch of sweaty kids playing COD and now it's like rappers and shit like that?
It's like a fraternity.
But at the same time, I do respect FaZe.
You know? I do.
Don't double down like that. Nah, they're all right. They're having a crack.
They're all right. They're having a crack. It's just, I mean, we know having misfits how weird it is having it become bigger than yourself. Like, it's a strange journey. And
with FaZe, it's just like, you're kind of a product of their environment. Yeah. When you're a fucking influencer in LA, I would never want to fucking be an influencer in LA. Either I would overdose on drugs or I'd put a fucking bullet in my brain. Like those are the only two fucking life paths.
Or you're drowning pussy. Take.
I feel like anyone that hates LA goes there, tries it, and then comes to Australia.
Australia's, dude, Melbourne's like LA without the crackheads, without the weird fucking culture of like girls wanting to fuck you for an Instagram follow.
The greasy fucking managers coming up like, oh, we can make you big. When I went there ages ago, because I stayed in the FaZe house and I was hanging out with Keem and all that, the amount of people I met and I was just like, what the fuck do you do? And he's like, listen, man, I'll make you big. Sign this contract.
Well, I stayed at the FaZe house for like a couple of weeks.
How many contracts did you see?
I saw a few contracts. One of which was almost completely disastrous for Misfits, I will say.
Yeah.
But the thing you notice about those houses that these big YouTubers rent is that they look expensive, but you tap the walls and they're fucking hollow.
All the furniture is like display furniture.
Yeah, it's literally like, it doesn't feel like a home at all. It feels gross and weird and cheap. It feels cheap. Yeah, it's crazy.
When I stayed there, I was like luxury house and like everything was broken. The projectors didn't work.
The aircon doesn't work. So it's just not how it looks at all. But if you show up on YouTube and you're like, yo, look at our dope mansion with our pool.
Look at our marble floors.
And we got girls over here. It looks a certain way. And you know, talking to the people that are behind managing these creators and making sure that things look clean and things look a certain way, they're just like flat out working all the time around these like young 20-year-olds that are just like,
it's about selling in this unobtainable lifestyle that is for content.
Well, if you take a bunch of kids that are really good at a video game out of their parents' house and put them in this high maintenance, expensive house, it's gonna
give you whatever you want, kid. You want to eat Oreos every day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner? Here's a fuck ton of Oreos. Enjoy your acne. We can get you Accutane. Like,
we'll get you plastic surgery to patch that up. You gotta look good as well, kid. So, you know, if you start losing your hair, we'll get a hair transplant for you.
We gotta get you fucking tattoos from the pedophile down the street.
Who was that?
Romeo Lacoste.
Mason got tattooed by that fucking pedophile in LA, and he's never been the same since. I swear to God,
he's getting it. Laser tattoo removal.
When you go to LA, everyone is very fucking weird.
Yeah.
And their solution to everything is doing something really extreme.
Mm-hmm.
Mason wasn't having a good time, and their solution was tattoo some stereotypical bullshit on your hand.
Don't you have like 6 logos on your ass?
Yeah, but that was funny.
This wasn't funny. This was pretentious, like,
yeah, this is
trash.
Pretentious bullshit. This is stupid.
And little did they know when they went in for the appointment that the tattoo artist was a fucking pedophile.
Yeah, what's that about?
Well, he was just a pedophile, wasn't he? You know? I don't want to say anything about it, but hey,
it's all right. He can't sue us. He lost the Keemstar lawsuit.
But yeah, their solution in LA when you're feeling down is to do something really extreme, which obviously is not healthy.
Or fill the void with material, dude.
And that's why we're glad to be in a city that's now 40 days COVID-free.
Not COVID-free anymore.
Wow, we have some overseas cases, but it's under control. Yeah.
We had no community transmission.
Yeah, no locally acquired. Everything's open. No one's wearing masks outside.
Yeah.
No one's nans are dying. We've got a nice little government set up.
People's nans are dying.
They are dying.
COVID.
Yeah, but you know what I mean.
Nans are always dying. It's kind of their thing.
Yeah.
Listen, we put in the hard yards here in Melbourne and in Victoria. We locked down and now things are great. Good for us.
It only took 136 days.
But, you know, we did what was necessary.
It didn't feel like that.
And it wasn't good for mental health and it wasn't good for content, but at least now we can go to a fucking bar.
Until someone says, let's put bat in the soup again. It'll be funny.
And then COVID was a really weird ego check for the world.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah.
Can you remember this like walking around like without COVID? You know, or like, oh, I'll just go to America like next week. Like,
yeah, can't do that. No. Remember the first night we all went out together after COVID? And I was like, we were all weirded out because like, fuck, we're sitting as a group. Oh my God, there are people in the other room. Mm, yeah. You weren't there. You were at home. What were you doing? You loved COVID.
Because that was Shall we finish this game?
Yes.
Do we need an updated tally of who's winning?
Yep.
So in the lead, we have Max, just tested positive for COVID. But coming up second is Swagger Souls.
Hey.
With, so when are we going to tell them about our Pokemon? Pokemon applied to it.
Did she?
Before the drama channels catch on for the quick buck, this is a joke, this is a joke. It was all going so well until I vouched for cuties on Netflix.
So my first one is Black Marker. Who was that?
Either of us.
Who's got horrible handwriting?
This guy right here.
Okay. As a white man, I think I speak for everyone when I say, that's racism. Racism is kind of outdated.
Let me read it for you.
So it's. Yeah, I mean, no. Show the handwriting and how it's laid out, so people don't think I'm fucking retarded.
It's not the best. As a white man, I think I speak for everyone when I say that racism is .. kind of outdated?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Drink for that
it's,
one.
Wait, it's two shots. It's two shots.
Oh yeah, it's gone. We're amping things up.
It's not a good tweet. I kind of wish that you got the other one.
Okay, that's soju.
It's one. Go ahead.
No, I did fucking almost half the bottle. Shouldn't die.
Oi, let's take a vote.
I thought we were on call.
I should do it again.
I want to go out to dinner
again?
After this.
Chad does it again.
No, I will throw up.
Again.
Yeah, have a quick munt and then we'll go to dinner.
Oh my fucking God.
One on the table.
Jazz.
There you go.
Legend.
Nice. All right, Max, you're up next.
Max? I'd say I was hacked, but... I'm honestly saying what's on my mind. And if you have a fucking problem with that, then unfollow me, assholes. Now I'll take a shot.
Wow. Hey, you gotta finish the bottle. I did half the bottle, you have to finish the other half.
Does that look like two shots?
I did half the bottle.
That's a hell of a follow-up to I hate women.
Yeah, right? I was hoping it'd come around
to
you.
Damn, Max, that could have been the best tweet of the year. You really down? Oh, Max is gonna be fucked after this.
God damn.
Wow. That was really good for a
like
straw.
Wow, that was good for a straw. Tweet the last picture on your camera roll. Oh no.
No, you can't look. You can't look. You have to agree to it or not.
No, you can look. I wrote it. You can look.
You can look, but don't tell us.
Okay.
Yeah. But still do it no matter what.
Okay.
What is it?
It's a screenshot of me. It's a screenshot. You don't want to see?
Tweet it.
I think that I will.
Yeah, okay. All right. All right.
I think that I will tweet
that.
Okay. It's not bad. It's just, you know, a kind of funny photo of me in a suit. Is this me standing?
That's good. That's a good tweet. That's a good tweet.
It's a nice follow-up to my little, my sequence of tweets tonight.
It looks like we've been hacked. Like they've gone through your phone camera and just found this awesome photo. Like this is it.
I was going to make some kind of meme out of that photo anyway.
The final one. I, for one, love women. No idea what Max Mofo is talking about. All right, I'll tweet it. Eggnog on the table.
Oh yeah!
Yes.
What the
Where's the eggnog?
Where's the eggnog for Christmas? Yeah. Go make the batch up, bitch. I mean, slave. I mean, assistant Laura. How much brandy did you put in there?
This looks fucking munted. We have a container full of eggnog and a black plastic ladle. And are we putting alcohol in it?
Yeah, we'll get fresh cups. We'll get fresh cups. I don't want to mix it with that. Okay. Oh, this is going to be so bad on the top of everything else. I'd say 3 seconds of pouring. You ready? Count it. Right.
Uh huh.
Count it.
One, 1,000, 2, 1,000, 3, 1,000.
There we go.
All right, and a bit for good luck.
Now you need to sprinkle some fucking nutmeg over there.
Ooh, very nice.
Nutmeg contains cyanide.
Ready to knock it up.
Chad be like, I don't want to make a mess.
You said it would be funny.
One glass, oh my God. Two glasses.
Jesus,
you're not even trying.
What happened?
Cruz is sitting here this whole episode. Man, they're so Drop clean. They've been so clean.
Chat, I'll give you a tip.
Yeah.
Hold the glass over the container and it will not fall when you ladle it in.
What? Well, boys, it's been a great episode. Been through the ups and the downs and we're here now.
Well said.
May everyone watching, everyone here, have a Merry Christmas.
And a happy new year.
That's right.
Perfect.
Cheers. Cheers. Clinks all around.
To Pokimane. That has alcohol?
Yeah, a lot. That tastes good. And now I know why people get abusive around Christmas. It's the eggnog.
Are you guys, do you guys have an alcoholic taste?
What was that?
Does yours taste like alcohol?
Yeah.
Mine does not.
Hinty. Very slightly.
I can add more. I mean, I added almost fucking the whole bottle.
Can you taste mine?
One more for the road.
Jesus.
It tastes like mine.
Really?
We mixed it.
It's not supposed to taste disgusting.
Yeah, it's not supposed to taste like
alcohol. It tastes like fucking egg.
Egg grog. Why don't we call it egg grog?
Egg grog. Egg to the egg grog.
To the egg grog.
The egg grog.
Cheers. What do you want for Christmas, Chad?
A 2010 Nissan Cube. All right, it's boring. Max?
One of Ryan P's Rolexes.
One of Ryan P's Rolexes. I would like somebody else's girlfriend to root.
Hey, I'll drink to that, honestly. Honestly, I'll drink to that. Cheers.
It's beginning to feel a lot like Christmas.
It is. Let's go fuck each other.
Okay.